I believe that that actually that healthcare legislation is progressive and should actually be adopted by U.S. Senate, as actually it brings universal healthcare coverage to millions of uninsured Americans. Actually, it's not a single-payer system, to which Democrats will never have agreed, as Senator Mike Warner once told that in case of a single-payer system, he would have switched sides to Republicans. But I believe that such an Arizona Republican like John Keel and another Republican Senator Thune will line about healthcare bill, healthcare legislation, but it would take funds from Medicare, it would diminish Medicare funds. It will actually, healthcare legislation will become part of Medicare system, but it won't actually ruin Medicare system. In the second, it won't bring down the benefits of the elderly Medicare recipients. It actually won't bring any new taxes to against working class people or pensioners, social security recipients or middle classes, none whatsoever. Because it's because Republicans are prostitutes of imperialism. They sold out to the rich and powerful tycoons and wealthy individuals, madmen, tax evaders. So that the Republicans actually oppose raising taxes against the rich and powerful, as actually they are against the interests of the American public. Republicans are practically public enemies because they oppose healthcare legislation. Healthcare legislation will enable millions of Americans to get mental health treatment and physical treatment as well in the first place. And I believe that healthcare legislation would enable Americans to become productive nation and happy nation. But otherwise, crime rate will go up because people who don't get mental or physical healthcare will often resort to crime as the alternative to solving the health problems, health-related problems. And I believe that Democrats should target Senators Thune and John Keel, and when we get for election, we probably should bring them down, those corrupt Republican senators, and take their position, win their positions, and should investigate them for corruption charges, because they might have sold out to the rich and powerful for money, and such processes of imperialism, like that John Keel and Thune, they're trying to defraud the American public even out of its Medicare. We lie to the seniors, we lie to the American public in terms about that healthcare legislation might have taken money from Medicare and would have reduced benefits, Medicare benefits to elderly. We are lying to it. Healthcare legislation will never touch a single penny of Medicare recipients' benefits. It will never reduce Medicare. And I believe actually Democrats will replenish Medicare and medical Medicare funds and Social Security funds by raising taxes against rich and wealthy tax evaders and rich oil corporations and rich wealthy gasoline corporations, who rip off American public, who rip off American motorists every day, who add gasoline alternators to gasoline like MBT, in order to rip off huge profits and evaporate gasoline too fast. And I believe that these wealthy individuals deserve the tax to be raised to a highest level of 80%. 80% over millions of dollars of income, because they're ripping off American public, and they just lousy people who steal money from working class people. And I believe that Democrats will prevail. President Obama will soon sign with healthcare legislation, which is very important for the American public to remain healthy and treat their disease, public disease, people disease, because otherwise people, American public won't be able to get that very much healthcare from private insurers. The private insurers normally spy on the clientele, and whenever they determine that the client is likely to get some serious disease, they raise premiums significantly, maybe 100%, 200%. In order for that person, the group of persons we are spying on, will drop the coverage. And then we get rid of that way of those sick insured clients in order to not to pay their premiums, not to pay their coverage. So these are, we could do consumer fraud, and in order to prevent that to happen, insurance companies should be regulated. We're regulated by laws. That laws regulate insurance companies should actually state that insurers are not able to change the condition of contract, none at all. Won't be able to raise insurance premiums none at all within 5 years at least. Of a contract, and during the contract, and we should only raise those premiums only to negotiate a new contract with an insured client. So therefore, insurance company have no right to defraud customers or clients out of coverage by increasing their premiums 100%, for instance.